Burnout in My Pants Paradise is a game that is old enough to get a girlfriend, and it was created by a studio that had relations with EA, and we all know how that's gonna go, and is heralded as one of racing's all-time classics. Developed by the 90 people that work in an office somewhere in Guildford, UK, and are probably more known for their work with Need for Speed rather than whatever this is, in this game you can experience many wonders and thrills, such as destroyed cars that make Forza look like a joke, the setting of what might possibly be GTA 4's Liberty City, because they came out within 3 months of each other. Intense racing that will make you question if you are actually in a Burnout game or not, and jumps and stunts that'll make it seem like it's an action movie directed by John Wick. This is the final game in the mainline Burnout series, before EA decided to pull the plug after both them and Criterion had some creative differences. It's the culmination of one of gaming's long-forgotten racing franchise, and honestly, the franchise that deserves to return in the spotlight. This is Burnout Paradise. DMCA music is here. Run! This cinematic of cars, bikes, and a lot of other stuff is dope. It kind of makes me feel like I'm playing Forza a little bit with the intros to Horizon games, so good job on nailing the bar. This game has been around for nearly 15 years, so I wouldn't be surprised if the servers aren't active. Yet it still sucks, because I can't clown on this game's online mode then. Here, there's quite a lot of news about the game and online services, but there's also the exact date, time, and potentially even the weather outside for when I recorded this video. I'm sorry, but how and why? We enter Paradise City to get a welcome cinematic, and immediately, I had to question if I was in Liberty City, because let's be honest, that's what this game looks like.
As a newcomer to the city, you've been granted a learner's permit.
Sweet, I'm a black figure, how have I not been arrested yet?
This is Crash FM, and
oh god, the DMV, I hate this place. No!
First thing we need is a picture for your learner's permit. This'll have to do for now. If you had an Xbox Live Vision camera connected, we could have used something more personal.
Xbox Vision Connect requires a Kinect to use. That's not saying that I have one, but even if I did, those things were so hated that I wouldn't even use it because I'd become cringe. Why did the damage physics look better than Forza was pulling off at the time in 2008? Surely this is not something unique to Burnout in its time, right? Angus Wharf. There's no driver, what? So who's driving then? Either that, or they simply forgot to program a model in, which is rather hilarious, considering that I don't think you'd want to be in an accident in this game if you were the model. I did pause, though, to find a way to turn off the music so that I don't get DMCA'd, and stumbled into this in-game store. It's here that I realized that this game had a lot of DLC in its life. Mostly car packs, mind you. So it's great to hear that this game was loved both by its developers and player base. Also, can we just listen to this car for a few minutes? Because holy crap, for 2008, this sounds great. The only thing that I wish this game had is a speedometer of some sort, you know, like in virtually every other racing game ever. Apparently doing a race requires you to do a burnout at any intersection. You know, why can't we just start a race with like a girl doing a dance or, I don't know, some white dude waving a green flag? Thus begins a timed race in which we gotta race somewhere to win a car. Alright.
Event wins are shown on your driver's license. Keep up your winning streak to advance to the next license.
I've just now realized, why can't I set my GPS in any way on this map? You'd think you could, because this is a racing game and you want to know where you're going, but you can't. The fact that the game changes camera angles anytime you enter a place like, you know, boost refills or repair shops, kinda sucks, so wish that wasn't there. We head to the junkyard to acquire that new car that I mentioned about 30 seconds ago, but before that, we get introduced to a slew of bikes.
What?
Because apparently I want to die going 200 miles per hour down a street, I guess? Well, that sounded rough. Why didn't the bikes get that treatment? I decided to explore the city a bit by blazing through this tunnel and then getting into an accident with this truck. But holy crow, the damage in this game is better than I expected, and it really shows. There's these smash gates that are basically shortcuts. I'm not entirely sure why there's 400 of them, but hey, I guess Criterion was just trying to replicate the 2008 version of 900 Korok Seeds. I then decided to commit suicide by ramming this bus. Now, let's race with some other people in the same vehicle.
Get ready to race. You are here. Race south to Lone Stallion Ranch. Takedowns earn a chunk of boost in the aggression cost.
Tactical map searching technique. What an idiot!
Congratulations! That win was all you needed to upgrade your license to a Class D.
Aw, snap, son, I'm getting a Class D license! I never want to say that again, just for the record. Planned. Alright, time to race again. I find it funny that even when we're racing, we still put our turn signals on for when we're gonna turn. I mean, at least we respect the law in Paradise City. Sort of. Apparently, if you destroy someone's car, you get to keep it. I guess this was kinda like the Forza Horizon head-to-head before Forza Horizon even existed. Although it's not head-to-head because you're basically just killing each other. I spent a while looking for this man named Nakamura the Car Whisperer, and eventually, we duked it out pretty hard.
When you see another driver, take him down to win his car.
Okie dokie!
Take down another driver, his wreck is taken to the junkyard. Find a junkyard to pick it up.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have just killed a Honda owner. Here come the fan clubs. We make haste for the junkyard to hop into our new ride.
They're also the only cars that can perform burnouts when you use all your boost in one go.
Jesus Christ, I sound like I'm in a riced out Honda Civic. Someone get me earplugs and a gun.
Out. Use it all in one go to perform a burnout.
Son, I'm pretty sure that's not how you do a burnout because I'm pretty sure boost does not make you spin into a wall like a Mustang. Anyways, let's do a race in this beat-down Civic and see how we do. Clutch, that was planned, don't worry about it whatsoever, nope. After this, I decided to go to explore the city, for real this time, and in doing so, I found this train wreck where Thomas the Dank Engine resides, failed a jump and went for a swim with the fishies, visited the local docking area, and proceeded to get myself stuck on top of someone's house. I also swapped cars to the bag of mesquite barbecue chips so that we can experience as many cars as possible. Now this car sounds rad. It's so rad, let's do another race with it. Went the wrong way, don't worry about it, everything's fine.
Hunter Vegas is now cruising around Paradise City. If you see it, shut it down to add it to your car.
Wow, I didn't know my city was a discount Buick in disguise. Yep, thanks EA, real cool. It took less than 20 seconds, and I found this Vegas Buick, and I delivered justice. Okay, round two, let's do this.
The Hunter Vegas has been delivered to your junkyard.
Okay, you know, if there was a driver in there, I think we'd be dead. Just saying. We return to the junkyard to hop into the Vegas mobile, complete with a weird chick on both sides, and let's be honest, it kind of sounds like some kind of washing machine. And naturally, to end off the video, we gotta do a race with the Vegas Mobile.
This is a race. You are here. Race northwest to the country club.
Wrong turn, I repeat, wrong turn. Completely saved, literal god at work, don't ever question me again.